Cystitis imaging. Cystitis defined as inflammation of the renal bladder from any cause. Cystitis is a clinical diagnosis. Normal urinary bladder ultrasound. Suprapubic abdominal ultrasound of the bladder demonstrates this patient. Urinary bladder partly filled with a clear urine. Urine normally must be clear. No any abnormal echoes. Healthy bladder content should be appear anechoic. Maybe urine anechoic reverberation artifact can be seen. Suprapubic scan of this bladder, dorsal disc bladders, symmetric seminal vesical scenes, behind the bladder roof, hyperechoic reverberation echoes are seen. Ultrasound artifact produced by multiple reflection and object of acoustic impedance at two different body to water. In this case, sound wave reflected back into bladder from transducer skin interface. Normal bladder wall 3 to 5 mm thick when fully distended. Thickness of the bladder depends on how full it is. In a full bladder, thickness decreased approximately to 2 to 3 mm. When filled, normal bladder wall should have a plain appearance without any irregularity. Transrectal ultrasound of bladder urine from right scrotum gives this color with Doppler study. Bladder volume can be calculated by scanning bladder transverse longitudinally using this formula. Volume of bladder volume of urine equal height width depth multiplied by 0.52. Measurement of post void residual urine with this formula also. Transverse longitudinal EB 3 dimension multiplied by 0.52. Two, cystitis classification either infectious, bacterial or infectious non-bacterial cystitis or non-infectious non-bacterial cystitis. Infectious non-bacterial, viral, mycobacterial, chlamydial, fungal, schistosomal, eosinophilic cystitis. Non-infectious non-bacterial cystitis. Interstitial cystitis most common type in this category. It's painful syndrome, painful bladder syndrome, radiation induced cystitis, chemical cystitis, autoimmune hypersensitivity, drug induced cystitis like cyclophosphamide, radiation cystitis, foreign body cystitis, chemical cystitis, cystitis associated with other conditions like diabetes, kidney stones, HIV, enlarged prostate, spinal injuries. Bladder wall thickening. Bladder wall thickening differential diagnosis for bladder wall thickening depends on whether bladder adequately distended. Bladder wall thickened if more than 3 mm when distended, more than 5 mm when non-distended. If bladder not distended, then it's difficult to exclude artifactual thickening from a collapsed bladder. If the bladder wall adequately distended, then differential may be developed based on whether bladder diffusely thickened or vocally thickened. Diffuse bladder wall thickening, bladder outlet obstruction, neurogenic bladder, infectious cystitis, cystitis from radiation or chemotherapy. Vocal bladder wall thickening, first cause urothelial cell carcinoma of the bladder, transitional cell carcinoma, artifact bladder products or blood products or clot. In this case, wall not enhance this blood products and the clot will not enhance on post contrast CT or MR. No vascularity in coral Doppler. These clots may be adherent to the bladder wall like tumor, but clot more likely to have a concave margin unlike tumor. Other bladder neoplasm cause vocal bladder wall thickening, squamous cell carcinoma of the bladder, adenocarcinoma of the bladder lymphoma, small cell bladder tumor, bladder paraganglioma, bladder wall leiomyoma. Cystitis more commonly diffuse than vocal, but may mimic neoplasm. adjacent inflammatory process like diverticulitis, also may cause vocal bladder wall thickening. Cystitis cystica and cystitis glandularis may mimic bladder cancer, amyloidosis of the bladder, and myoclonicia, which is both are rare. First type of cystitis which we talk about is microbial or bacterial cystitis. This is most common type. Imaging features of bacterial cystitis. In acute infectious cystitis, we found heterochoric urine in ultrasound, diffuse mural urinary bladder wall thickening, particularly if marked more than 1 cm, hypoenhancing in CT, edematous at T2-weighted MR, increased compared to previous study, urothelial hyperenhancement, minimal thickened, uniform circumferential, perivesical fat inflammatory changes, mural bladder abscess, intramural exophytic collection, internally hypoattenuating, 10 to 15, Hounsfield non-enhancing, irregular oven thick peripheral enhancement, upper bladder site, by Doppler study, no internal vasculature seen within the abscess. What is meant by heterochoric urine? Urine appear in ultrasound with multiple echoes with urinary bladder. This multiple echoes may be pus in bacterial cystitis, epithelial cells, blood cells, leukocytes, and proteins. Normal urine appears anechoic in a patient with chronic bladder infection, and the bladder content appears cloudy because of reflection of leukocytes and the protein. These examples of heterochoric urine, thickened urinary bladder wall, debris in the bladder, hypertrophied mucosa also seen at urethras. The sonogram of all the male adolescent recurrent urinary tract infection, we found heterochoric urines, multiple echoes within urinary bladder, acute urinary retention with chronic prostate obstruction over distended bladder. This is followed by collected by catheterizations, diffuse wall thickening. This is chronic bacterial bladder infection in female patient with post void residual volume. We see this is examples of heterochoric urine, multiple echoes seen within urinary bladder, which a result of chronic infection, cloudy urine, as a result of pus, proteins, leukocytes. This is old permanent transcatheter for bladder outlet obstruction. We found the bladder content urine is cloudy because of urinary tract infection, bacterial cystitis. Sonographic appearance of another heterochoric urine. This is case of papillary transitional carcinoma, male is obstructive benign prostatic hyperplasia. We see non-echoic urine result of hematuria. In this case, heterochoric urine not result of pus cell, but result of hematuria red blood cells. We saw also thickened bladder wall. Blood clot also may cause echogenic structure or heterochoric urine. Large coagulated hematoma in this patient post-operative. Complication following TUR or TURP. This is also big tail catheter with typical hyperechoic double contour of urethral catheter. There is also heterochoric urine and we see stone shadowing. This is post void residual measurement. After cystoscopy, we found hyperechoic air inside bladder lumen. Acute infection cystitis in this patient with CT, poorly controlled diabetes dehydrated. We found this CT image urinary tract bladder with catheter, marked circumferential mural thickening with hypoenhancing edematous wall, and urothelial enhancement. This is also same patient urinary tract infection, mural bladder abscess. circumferential mural thickening from detrusor muscle hypertrophy, urothelial hyper enhancement. This patient complete from case before urosepsis. We investigate this patient. Thickening of the urinary bladder, mural thickening of the urinary bladder wall, persistent urothelial enhancement, appearance of inflammatory stranding, fat stranding perivesical fat planes, deformed sizable collection attached to the bladder dome, with non-enhancing hypoattenuating Hounds field contained and enhancing peripheral rim, result abscess formation. Mural bladder abscess, this all demand mural bladder abscess, urinary tract infection, multi-bladder CT depict poorly distensible bladder with mural thickening, urothelial hyper enhancement consistent with active urinary tract infection, fluid-like collection and irregular enhancement along posterolateral aspect. 6 weeks later, after antibiotic treatment, resolve abscess, persistent mural thickening and infectious urothelial enhancement. Follow up later on with T2, abscess disappears completely. Active infectious cystitis, and this is woman with several microbes, urosepsis after inconclusive abdominal pelvic CT, contracted bladder with false catheter, diffuse mural thickening, multivocal high thickening, edematous region, best appreciated in fat saturation. After acute infectious cystitis, this patient mural bladder abscess, and this patient MR bilography with fat suppressed, show bilateral hydronephrosis, contracted bladder, prominent inflammatory changes, surrounding extraperitoneal fats, plain additional sagittal T2, showed vocal thickening, intramural fluid collections, and medical treatment reveals appearance of abnormal mural changes. Interstitial cystitis, painful bladder syndrome. Bladder pain syndrome is a painful bladder disease characterized by chronic urinary urgency, frequency, pain without evidence of bacterial infection. Nearly 90% of patients with interstitial cystitis are women. Triad of urgency, frequency, bladder or pelvic pain in the absence of bacterial infection. Or definable pathology is definition of interstitial cystitis. Interstitial cystitis is diagnosed in basis of its clinical feature. The cause of painful bladder syndrome unknown, but abnormalities is the thickness or structure of the lining of the bladder are believed to play a role in the development of painful bladder syndrome. Most common symptom urinary frequency includes multiple nighttime voids, urinary urgency, suprapubic pelvic pain related to the bladder filling. Associated symptoms: dyspareunia, pain with intercourse, chronic constipation, slow urinary stream, food sensitivities that worsen symptoms, radiating pain in the groin, vagina, rectum, or sacrum. Cystitis cystica, cystitis glandularis. All of them presented with lower urinary tract symptoms, urinary tract infection, and intermittent hematuria. Common chronic reactive inflammatory disorder which occur in the setting of chronic irritation. Ultrasound features. Ultrasound features cystic submucosal cyst of bladder, bulboidal mass arising from inferior wall of bladder, bladder wall thickened more than 1.5 cm at trigone, papillary mass arising from trigonal region may be malignant, cancer bladder at base, papillary mass with calcification, Patient with present hypertension, bulboidal lesion at retrovesical junction. Differential diagnosis of cystitis cystica, it's bladder tumor. Cystitis cystica, submucosal cyst of the bladder. This is elderly male present and distinct small cyst in submucosal surface of the bladder, just above neck of bladder, in close proximity to upper surface of prostate. The cystitis cystica submucosal cyst of this patient. Doppler study show lack of significant vascularity to the cystic lesion in the submucosal region of urinary bladder. Urinary bladder cyst in this case measure 4.5 mm in size, seen wallet. This ultrasound appearance submucosal cyst of urinary bladder highly suggestive of cystitis cystica. Cystitis cystica and cystitis glandularis. Oblique view during eye view show lobulated contour of bladder with annular feeling defect. Bulboidal lesion close to the left urethrovesical junction cause hydroureter. This one of presentation of cystitis cystica. Trigonal mass lesion mimicking malignant lesion ultrasonography. This also one presentation of cystitis cystica, cystitis glandularis. Cystitis cystica relatively rare and poorly understood lesion of the urinary bladder mucosa, resulting from cyst formation within hypertrophied clusters of bladder mucosal cells. There are two schools of thought regarding the significance of cystitis cystica of the urinary bladder. Some believe this lesion to be a pre-malignant condition, whilst other maintain the cystitis cystica just incidentally finding of little significance. Other differential diagnosis cases include retention cysts of the prostate or urinary bladder. Cystitis cystica in IVB appear a lobulated outline for urinary bladder with nodular feeling defect. On CT, hypervascular bulboidal masses within urinary bladder. On MR, T1 may be seen as low signal bulboidal lesion. T2 low signal lesion with central branching hyperintensity. Central hyperintensity enhance in contrast and represent vascular stroke. Eosinophilic cystitis is another rare chronic inflammatory disease of the bladder. Single mass are observed more frequently than multiple bladder mass may be sessile. Bladder wall may appear normal or second. Cystic variant with an enhancing wall may be seen. MR image show mass hyperintense relative to the muscle with T1. Isointense with T2, enhanced after IV administration of contrast material. In the fibrotic stage of eosinophilic cystitis, bladder small contracted, there may be resultant hydronephrosis. This is eosinophilic cystitis case in T1 image, single sessile mass arising from posterior bladder wall, mass mildly hyperintense relative to muscle, sagittal gadolinium enhanced, show enhancement of the mass and the adjacent bladder wall. Eosinophilic cystitis in this CT cases, axial sagittal reconstruction, contrast enhanced CT show sequoid cystic mass arising from anterior dome of the bladder. Malacoplakia term signifies soft plaque. Malacoplakia rare chronic granulomatous condition that can affect any organ, with urinary tract being most common system involved. Within urinary tract, bladder most frequently affected organ, with 40% of patients with malacoplakia having bladder involvement, 16 renal involvement. These found predominantly in women with a female to male ratio 4:1. Patients of any age may develop malacoplakia, big occurrence in middle age. These more common in patients with diabetes mellitus or immunocompromised, such as autoimmune disease or acquired immune deficiency or recent transplant recipient. Presenting system malacomalacia include gross hematuria, signs of UTI, such as hesitancy, urea frequency. Patient may have variable protein urea or azoladi leukocyte erythrocytes in urine. Imaging characteristic malacoplakia varied, may be multiple bulboid vascular solid masses or circumferential wall thickening, associated with vesicoureteric reflux and dilutation of upper UT. Malacoplechia may be extremely aggressive, invading perivesical space, can even cause bone destruction. Ring-shaped bladder calcification represent adherent calculi described. Less common radiologic manifestations that predominantly retrovesical mass involving uterus or extravesical anterior mass. This malacoplechia axial C2, she marked circumferential wall thickening. This is malacoplechia axial CT upper lower pelvis, show large irregularly enhancing mass which is continuous with the bladder, not diffuse thickening of the bladder wall. Emphysematous cystitis. Emphysematous cystitis, gas forming infection of the bladder wall. In brain radiograph, conventionally show characteristic curvilinear or mottled areas of increased radiolucency in the region of urinary bladder, separate from more posterior rectal gas. Intraluminal gas will be seen as air fluid level that change with patient position, and when adjacent to non-dependent mucosal surface may have a cobblestone repeated nickel appearance. The thought to reflect irregular thickening produced submucosal plips. And CT highly sensitive examination allow early detection of intraluminal or intramural gas. CT useful in evaluating other cause of intraluminal gas, such as enteric fistula from adjacent bowel carcinoma or inflammatory disease like diverticulitis. An ultrasound can demonstrate echogenic air within bladder wall with a dirty shadowing artifact. Ultrasound commonly demonstrate diffuse bladder wall thickening and increased echogenicity. The sonogram emphysematous cystitis demonstrate bladder wall thickening and hyperechoic foci due to intramural versus intraluminal gas. This is also hyperechoic foci due to gas within adjacent to the second bladder wall. This is brain X-ray with characteristic lucency, intramural gas inside the wall. This is in case of hip fractures. This is another case of emphysematous cystitis. We sound linear, curvilinear, circular lucency inside the bladder wall of air. This is CT characteristic also show intramural inside bladder wall air present with air fluid levels in the bladder lumen intraluminal. This characteristic also of emphysematous cystitis brain X-ray show this line lucency of gas outlining bladder wall because present inside bladder wall. This is also unseen with this artifact in the ultrasound. This case of emphysematous cystitis in CT, we see intramural air present with characteristic shape inside. This suprapubic ultrasound show hyperechoic area anterior bladder wall, indicator of intraparietal air reverberation echoes, and dirty shadow associated with intravesical air. As we see, this is image bladder wall, hyperechoic aspect of the wall with reverberation artifact echoes. Backward wall irregular characterized by presence of more superficial gaseous bubbles. This is axial CT with contrast irregular parietal bladder wall thickening, presence of intracystic, intraparietal air, intracystic intraparietal air. We note peripheral air bubble implying fluid accumulations in favor of subserosal bladder rupture. Air bubble also present in the left ureter. This is also case of emphysematous cystitis. We see in this is ultrasound hyperechoic bladder wall of irregular aspect in the posterior part. Presence of repeat echoes down. The lack of anterior bladder was suggesting existence of intraluminal air. also في diffraction of echoes with impedes visualization of retrovesical pelvic structure. This is case unprepared. And this is X-ray concave arcuate linear hyperlucency at the top of iliopelvic branch, assist of cystic intraparietal air and hypogastric fluid air fluid level. The associated presence of intracystic air. This is ultrasound to irregular hyperechoic bladder wall, irregular hyperechoic bladder wall. Retrovesical pelvic structure not visualized. Bladder content heterogeneous. Presence of liquid level suggestive of biuria. This is radiograph show identified distended bladder with air content and visualization of bladder wall also spontaneously with air. Emphysematous cystitis. This is emphysematous cystitis also in this case congestive heart failure, diabetes, obstructive lung disease. CT demonstrate urinary bladder with linear gas attenuations. Linear gas attenuation. It change along right lateral and upper posterior walls. Associating finding include inflammatory stranding. Very vesical fat plane, small bilobulated fluid like intraprostatic collections. Intraprostatic collections. Resolution of these changes later on after therapy. What's the differential diagnosis of gas in the urinary bladder? Iatrogenic IDC by far the most common cause, like cystoscopy. Emphysematous cystitis, as we see before, intraluminal intramural gas, most frequently patient with diabetes mellitus. Fistula also cause gas in the urinary bladder, introvesical, colovesical, most common due to diverticulitis and colorectal carcinoma. Rectovesical fistula, vesical fungus bore most frequently candida, patient, debilitated patient, also foreign body trauma may cause gas in the urinary bladder. These examples of gas in the urinary bladder, colovesical fistula, sigmoid carcinoma, emphysematous cystitis causing of gas in the urinary bladder, rectovesical fistula due to rectal carcinoma, schistosomiasis. It's one cause of the cystitis, infection with schistosomiasis. Imaging finding mirror pathologic course. In acute phase, nodular bladder wall thickening observed at urography or cross-sectional, there may be ureteral dilatation. Chronic phase characterized by contracted fibrotic sequoid bladder with calcification. This calcification typically curvilinear and represent a large number of calcified X within the bladder wall. Distal ureteral calcification may also present. A mass may be secondary through inflammation or complicating carcinoma, typically squamous carcinoma. This is presented with urinary tract infection, case of schistosomiasis, bladder ultrasound, show calcified schistosomiasis, IG within bladder mucosa, anterior wall, easily detectable. The schistosomiasis ultrasound so bladder wall show nodular bladder wall thickening, appearance more typical in the acute phase of infection. This is schistosomiasis EB radiograph and axial CT of the bladder show curvilinear calcification of the bladder wall which extend to the distal left ureter. Calcification representing abundance of calcified ova typically seen in chronic phase of infection. Schistosomiasis with superimposed squamocellular carcinoma. Unenhanced and post-contrast CTD show marked asymmetric solid mural thickening with poor enhancement along anterior right lateral and superior bladder aspect. Additional finding colon thin calcification and left posterolateral bladder wall intraluminal stones. CT cystography with retrograde contrast filling show extensive bladder occupation by tumor. Crohn's disease one cause of cystitis and cystoscopy CT most useful diagnostic tools. cystoscopy show fistula may be directly visualized. There may be pus, feces, pollus edema in the bladder. CT airways in bladder, vocal irregularity of the wall, most commonly right side of the bladder, and tessering of second adjacent bowel usual finding. This case of Crohn's with cystitis fistula to the bladder, contrast enhanced coronal CT, wall thickening distal small bowel, adjacent bladder. This radiograph show small bowel contrast study show intravesical fistula. This intravesical fistula extending from abnormal segment of ileum to the bladder. Tuberculosis one causes of cystitis. In acute phase bladder TB, sonographic finding include irregular mucosal mass due to coalescing tubercle with ulceration and edema, diffuse wall thickening trabeculation. Urography show bladder mucosa irregular, may be urethral stricture and thickening with obstruction or affixed and the butulous vesicoureteric junction orifice resulting vesicoureteric reflux. In chronic phase imaging finding sequelae contracted bladder from fibrosis. Diminution of bladder volume account for symptom of frequency. May be associated calcification in seminal vesicle. But bladder wall calcification rare, seen only after healing. Bladder TB may complicated by fistula or sinus tract. All this complication rare, demonstrated better in CT and the MR. This TB EB radiograph obtained show irregularity of the bladder. There is also distortion irregularity of the renal calyces. Diverticulitis with a fistula to the bladder. Diverticulitis also one causes of gas in the bladder, one causes of cystitis, diffuse wall thickening of sigmoid colon, with adjacent vocal cheek wall gas containing abscess. Coronal CT show abscess immediately adjacent to the bladder, fistula forming with gas within bladder lumen, diffuse bladder wall thickening. Sigmoid diverticulitis, vocal thickening on the thin left posterior part of the bladder, adjusted to inflamed sigmoid, moderate amount of air present in the bladder, find compatible with colovesical fistula. CT scan also show case with pneumaturia and prior diverticulitis, air in the bladder outside of fistula's communication between sigmoid and the bladder, colovesical fistula, radiation and chemotherapy cystitis. Chemotherapy cystitis from cyclophosphamide. This sonogram shows diffuse wall thickening, axial CT show enhancement of the mucosal surface, as well as diffuse wall thickening. Hyperemic mucosa may ulcerate, cause significant hematuria. Radiation cystitis, chronic change, axial CT show vocal thickening and calcification of the right posterior bladder wall. Subtle widening of pre-sacral space, infiltration of pelvic musculature with fatty infiltration. Radiation cystitis with fistula. This is AB obtained during cystography, shows a fistula's communication between bladder and the perivesical space, axial CT obtained, confirm presence of contrast material posterolateral to the bladder, not radiation change within bone. False catheter balloon. Hemorrhagic cystitis. Severe hemorrhagic cystitis may develop after chemotherapy or irradiation of the bladder. Chemotherapy related cystitis occur from systemic or local chemotherapy. Radiation injury may result from external, interstitial, or intracavitary. Hemorrhagic cystitis. Thickening bladder wall in this boy with juvenile leukemia. This is grade 3 hemorrhagic cystitis, irregular thickening of the bladder wall with hypervascularization, small blood clots in this old girl with lymphocytic leukemia, segmental bladder wall thickening with mucosal, submucosal edema and hypervascularization, bladder wall thickening, grade 2 hemorrhagic cystitis with acute lymphocytic leukemia. Grade of hemorrhagic cystitis variety, According to average thickness of the bladder wall, grade 1.58 centimeter, grade 2.93, grade 3 1.4, grade 4 hemorrhagic cystitis 1.9. Hemorrhagic cystitis, another case, show diffuse irregular thickening of the bladder wall with turbid content and echogenic content in ultrasound. Severe bladder wall thickening with edema, loss of definition of structure of surrounding tissue, grade 3 hemorrhagic cystitis. This patient non-Hodgkin lymphoma, significant thickening of the wall with edema, inflammatory reaction around the bladder wall, surrounding tissue, hypervascularization clot on the bladder lumen, inflammatory pseudotumor, another presentations of cystitis, pseudosarcomatous fibromyxoid. Inflammatory pseudotumor is an non-neoblastic proliferation of myelofibroblastic spindle cells and the inflammatory cells with myxoid component. Patient present most commonly with ulcerating bleeding mass, hematuria, and voiding symptom. Other signs symptom include fever and iron deficiency anemia. Condition more common in adult with mean age diagnosis reported 38. Inflammatory pseudotumor occurring in children, rare in neonate, has been reported. This bulboid inflammatory pseudotumor, coronal T1 and gadolinium enhanced, fat suppressed T1, gadolinium enhanced, fat suppressed T1, T2, show enhancing bulboidal mass into bladder lumen. Cystic inflammatory pseudotumor, contrast axial material enhanced CT, show predominant cystic mass arising from anterior bladder wall, predominant cystic mass arising from anterior bladder wall, this bladder lumen encroached by this mass. This is invasive inflammatory pseudotumor, transverse ultrasound and axial CT, enhanced axial gadolinium enhanced T1 MR, show large lobulated mass arising from a lateral wall of the bladder with significant extravesicular extension. Inflammatory pseudotumor axial T2 show lobulated bulboid mass arising from anterior wall of the bladder with central hyper intensity, low peripheral signal intensity, urinary bladder trabeculations. Urinary bladder trabeculation in signs may be related to cystitis or other causes. Urinary bladder trabeculation in case of lower urinary tract obstruction. Sonogram urinary symptom, all the males show urinary tract symptoms. Ultrasound show evidence of trabeculation of the urinary bladder, seen as fold of hypertrophied bladder mucosa. This is cause of urinary tract obstruction, a lower urinary tract obstruction as a large prostate, show intravesicular enlargement of the median loop, and significant both voiding residual, and this is trabeculation. Bladder trabeculation graded from 0 to 3. Grade 0 no trabeculation. Grade 1 mild area affected less than half of the bladder and the depth of trabeculation less than 5 mm. Grade 2 moderate area affected greater than half of the bladder, depth of trabeculation 5 to 10 mm. Grade 3 severe area affected greater than half of the bladder, depth of trabeculation more than 10 millimeter. This is bilharziasis, another case shows semiasis of the urinary bladder, show thickening of the bladder, wall of the urinary bladder with extensive calcification. This is patient with urinary tract dysuria and hematuria. Sonogram also suggests diagnosis of schistosomiasis. This caused by contact water infested in parasite, thickening of the bladder wall, and calcification irregularity. Thank you.